Students, today we will start with the introduction of the next topic, that is unit number 2. It is called as a influence line diagram. Okay, so first of all I would like you to tell you the basic of the influence line diagram. Already I have posted the video of the introductory part of the influence line diagram yesterday. If you see that, you might know about the basic of the influence line diagram. So basically, this influence line diagram is also one of the method of the structural analysis by which we can determine the indeterminate structures. Okay, so as shown on the screen, let us start the introduction part. To statically determine and statically indeterminate structural analysis under the moving load. Okay, so what this first point represent is that this method, okay, is applicable for the dynamic loadings. Okay, it is not applicable for the static loading. The dynamic loadings are the loadings which are comes like a vehicle loadings. That is a moving vehicles. Okay, the load which is moving, it is comes under the category of the dynamic loading. So basically, influence line diagram is most commonly used for the analysis of the bridge structures. Okay, or the structure which is subjected to the moving loads. Okay, so it is also useful for the determination of the maximum internal action at the cross section of the member of a statically determined structure under the effect of moving loads, that is a live load. Then it is a common sense tell us that when a load is moving over the structure, the deflected shape of the structure will also vary. Okay, then in the process we can also arrive at a simple conclusion that due to the moving loads position on the structure, the reaction value is also vary. So from the designer point of view, it is very essential to have a safe structures. Okay, which doesn't exceed the limit of deformation and also the limit of load carrying capacity of the structure. So let us see the basic definition of the influence line diagram. Okay, so influence line diagram is nothing but a diagram whose ordinates, which is plotted as a function of a distance along the span, and it gives the value of an internal forces. Okay, it give the value of internal forces or reactions or a displacement at a particular point in a structure as a unit load, okay, which moves across the structures. Also, the influence line, it is a curve of the ordinate to which, at which any point equal to the value of a some particular function due to the unit load acting at that point. Okay, it also a line which represent the variation of either a reactions, shear force, shear moment, or the deflection at a specific point in a member as a unit concentrated force move over the member. So let us see the basic construction of an influence line diagram and the formulation of the various formula which is applicable for calculating the reactions, shear force and the moment in the numerical. So let us see that. So this is a particular, suppose if I consider a simply supported beam of any length, okay, A is the reaction at support A, B is the reaction at support B. Let I have to calculate the maximum bending moment and shear force at a particular point C at a particular distance x. Okay, I am interested in calculating the bending moment and shear force on the span AB at a distance C. So x be the distance, okay, which is to be measured from the left hand side. L is the total length of the span. Okay, so as per the basic principle of the ILD. Okay, and one more thing is that ILD influence line diagram was first discovered by Muller's. Okay, so therefore it is also called as a Muller principle and Batty principle. The Muller and Batty are the two scientists who first discovered this principle and give the statical equations for calculating the ILD of the various sections, that is beams, trusses, etc. So further, if you consider a particular point C on the span AB and I am required to calculate the maximum bending moment and shear force at this point, so let us see how to calculate this. Okay, first of all I have to consider a unit load which is to be acting at this particular point. Okay, so if I put this unit load on the support A, okay, so what will be the standard ILD as per the Muller principle is that just release this support on which the unit load is acting, so that the deflected shape will be like this, okay, and the reaction will be for support A will be 1 as the load is acting at that particular point, and here the reaction at point B it will be equal to 0, and the point where I have to calculate the particular SFD and BMT, here the reaction will be L minus X by L. Okay, why this L minus X? Because I have considered the distance X from A, so automatically the distance for BC or CB will be equal to L minus X, because the whole span is L. Okay, so reaction at C will be equal to L minus X by L. So here the reaction at A will be equal to 1 as we are considering the unit load which is applied at support A. Okay, and support B the reaction will be 0. Similarly, if I am interested in calculating the reaction at B here, so apply this unit load at B. So automatically the reaction at B will become 1 and the reaction at A become 0. Okay, so the reaction for RB, ILD for RB will be equal to at point C will be equal to X by L. Also remember that this is not a particular reactions part, this is a ILD, that is an influence line diagram for reaction A and B. Okay, now if I am interested in calculating the maximum shear force at this particular point C, so it will be equal to L minus X, though the diagram pattern will be like this. Okay, one triangle will be formed on the left hand side and one triangle will be formed on the right hand side. The left hand side triangle will always be positive and left hand side triangle will be negative, and the ordinate of the same will be L minus X by L at the top and X by L will be at the bottom. So this equations, okay, and this apex value will you always remember, because this need to be required while calculations of the shear force. So shear force for ILD at C will be equal to like this. Now if I am going to plot the BMD for ILD at point C, okay, so BM for the ILD point C will be equal to L minus X by L will be remain same, only we have to multiply the distance X, okay, as we need to require the bending moment at C, so we have to multiply the respective distance X, okay, with the ordinate of shear force. So when we have multiplied this ordinate into X distance, so this unit will be in kilonewton, so multiplied with the distance as a meter, so kilonewton meter as a apex will be formed as a bending moment at the top. Okay, so always the bending moment, okay, at the top at the apex will be X L minus X by L. So this formula you need to always remember. So this is a standard case or standard formula to calculate the SFD and BMD, okay, for ILD at a particular point. So let us see what varieties of numerical may ask in your examinations and how to calculate the same by using influence line diagram. Okay, so let us see that. Now first numerical I have considered: a system of concentrated load, roll beam left to right, roll of beam left to right, simply supported span of 10 meter is there. So this is a particular span, okay, this is a span of 10 meter girder or your beam is there, okay, 10 meter and 10 kilonewton loading leading. Okay, so this point is very very important. We need to calculate the absolute maximum shear force, we need to calculate the absolute negative shear force and absolute maximum bending moment. Okay, so there are n number of unknowns, okay, by which you can calculate the ILD. Here in this case we have to calculate the absolute maximum shear force, absolute maximum negative shear force and maximum bending moment. Okay, but the thing is that the 10 kilonewton load is acting, okay, so this is a train of load. Okay, here in ILD the load is given at a particular distance, so this is a 20 kilonewton, 10 kilonewton, 15 kilonewton, and this is 20 kilonewton and 10 kilonewton, and the distance is also given as a 2 meter, 1.5, 1 meter and 2 meter. Okay, so this is called as a train of load, train of load, just like a train of vehicles. If you construct a vehicle over this, okay, if you construct a vehicle over this, and if you draw the number of tires, okay, of a vehicles like this, okay, so this is the pattern is just like a load of the tire of a vehicle. Okay, this is a front tire, okay, this is the intermediate tires, and this is a rear tire, and this is a particular distance. So these are called as a train of vehicles or train of load. Okay, so first of all, what we are interested in to calculate the absolute maximum shear force. Okay, so for this, what we have to calculate, first of all, we have to draw the maximum ILD for the reaction at A. So when we apply the reaction at A, the unit load is applied at the reaction or at the support A. So here the unity one is formed, unit load one is formed, and here the reaction at B will be equal to zero, and here the ordinate will be formed at X, Y, and Z. Okay, why this X, Y, and Z is formed? Because what we are interested in, the 10 kilonewton load is acting, is leading. Okay, so we have to place this 10 kilonewton load here, then 50 kilonewton load here. Okay, 50 kilonewton here, then 20 kilonewton, and this 10 kilonewton. This is a 15 kilonewton load, not this. This is a 10 and 15 kilonewton load is there. Okay, why I'm put this 10 kilonewton load first here? Because here it is asking for 10 kilonewton load is leading. Okay, 10 kilonewton load is leading, and the beam is rolling. Roll of the beam is from left to right. It is going from left to right. This is a left part and this is a right form. So left to right ja raha hai. To isliye pehle 10 kilonewton ka load aapko pehle consider karna hai. Then 15 kilonewton, then 20, and then 10 kilonewton. We need not require to put this 20 kilonewton load over this span. Okay, so this is a very important part. Now, what I have to do? What I have done? I have put this 10 kiloton, 15 kiloton, 20 and 10 kiloton load here. Okay, so already we know the load 10 kiloton over the support A, and the ordinate is 1. But we need to calculate the ordinate under the different loads, other load, that is 15 kiloton, 20 kiloton and 10 kiloton. Okay, so this value will be considered as X, Y and Z. Now we know that the distance from this is 1.5. okay, this is 1.5. okay, this is 1 meter and this is 2 meter. Now we need to calculate the distance from here. Already we know that the total span is 10 meter. So 10 minus 1.5, the distance is 8.5. then this is 8.5. now 8.5 minus 1, that is equal to 7.5. okay, then 7.5 minus 2, that is equal to 5.5. okay, so this distance we must know. Okay, now using the similarity of triangle, we can calculate the ordinate. 1 by 10 is equal to X by 8.5, so it will equal to 0.85. okay, similarly Y distance we can calculate, similarly Z distance we can calculate. Okay, why we are calculating this ordinate? Because the formula for the shear force is that whatever the load acting over the particular point, we just multiply it with respect to their ordinate. Then directly by multiplying this ordinate, we can directly get the maximum shear force. Okay, so if you remember this particular theorem, or we can say that the method is applicable or based on the virtual work theorem that you have already seen in your engineering mechanics. What is the principle of virtual work? Whatever the load is acting on a particular point, if you multiply that particular load with particular the deflection, okay, of that load, okay, the deflection of the same, then you will get the respective shear force. Okay, so the same thing I have done here. So here, by using the similarity of triangle, I have calculated X, Y and Z. Now the maximum shear force will be 10 into 1. If you see that, this is the particular load and this is the load, and this is its respective ordinate. It will be equal to 10 into 1, then plus 15 into 0.83. okay, that X distance that I have calculated, then Y 20 into Y, and then 10 into 0.55. Excuse me. So shear force will be equal to 43.25 kilonewton. Okay, now as this diagram is plotted over the baseline, okay, so therefore the diagram, therefore the sign convention for the same will be positive. So here you can see that I have summed all these value. I have summed all this value. Okay, now the second case arises will be, this is the first case. Now second case, if I put this 20 kilonewton load over here at the first point, so therefore it will be under the load 20, 1 is 1, 10 under this 1 is 1, then 15, then 20, and then 10 kilonewton is there. Okay, so this is 1 kilonewton load is acting as it is, as a point 1. This is LMN, this is a ordinate, okay, under the load that we have to calculate by using the similarity of triangle. So this strain of load and with respect to distance we have to write here. This is 2 meter, this is 1.5 meter, okay, and then here also 1 meter, and this is 2 meter is there. Okay, so if you this is the total span is 10 meter, so 10 minus 2 8 meter. Okay, then 8 minus 1.5 6.5 meter, then 6.5 minus 1 5.5, 5.5 minus 2 3.5. so this is the second possible case where you will get the maximum shear force. So using the similarity of triangle, again you can calculate by similarity of triangle, 1 by 8 is equal to L by 6.5. okay, similarly, so you will get the value of L is 0.8, then MNO. okay, now shear force will be equal to the load multiplied by respect to ordinate. So you will get here the maximum absolute negative shear force will be equal to 52.25. okay, this is a maximum negative shear force and this is a maximum positive shear force. So whenever you will, we are asked to calculate the absolute maximum shear force, positive shear force, so always you have to diagram, draw the, plot the diagram like this, and you have to calculate the ordinates and you have to multiply the respective load multiplied with its respective ordinate, and you will get the answer like this. And this is the calculation for absolute maximum negative shear force like this. Okay, now next thing is absolute maximum, this is absolute maximum positive shear force. Okay, now next is maximum negative shear force. Now these are the train of load, 10 kilonewton, 20, 15, and then 10 and 20. Now for maximum negative shear force, what we have to do, we have to draw the diagram in the downward direction so that the negative shear force will be get. Okay, now here the reaction at RB is equal to 1 as the unit load is applied at 1. Okay, so the diagram pattern will be the triangular one like this, and here the ordinate we have to calculate like LMNO. okay, now here again the distance, the train of this load and the their distance we have to write here. Okay, and LMNO we have to calculate. Now what we have to do, multiply this particular load with respect to its ordinate. So 20 into 0.35 plus 10 into 0.55 plus 15 into 0.7 plus 10 into 0.55 plus 20 into 0.35. so by applying the load like this, you will get the maximum shear force, negative shear force as minus 49 kilonewton. Okay, now again 20 kilonewton, 10, 15 and 20 kilonewton load we have to apply it like this. Okay, so again by using the similarity of triangle, you will get the answer like this, and maximum negative shear force will be like this. Okay, so whenever you may ask to calculate the maximum negative shear force, so first of all you have to apply the loading like this, and then you have to apply the loading like this. Okay, like this. Okay, now the next question is to calculate the absolute maximum bending moment. So where you will get the maximum bending moment? Okay, so let us see that here. This is the 20 kiloton, 10 kiloton, 15, 20 and 10 kiloton load is there. So you have to put this 15 kiloton load at the center for the maximum ordinate. So how this ordinate will calculate it? We know that the formula, x is there, L minus x, okay, divided by L. X into L minus x by L. So what is the value of x? What is the value of x? Let us see that. Maximum bending moment we have to calculate. Okay, this is 10 meter, so maximum bending moment we have to calculate. So in this case L minus x by L we have to put here like this. So L minus x is there, 10 minus, okay, x distance we have to calculate. The total distance is 2. What is the distance for this? Same. Half distance is 5, okay, divided by L, that is 10, and 5 by 10 into this is 5 by 10, okay, this is 0.25 into x is there equal to 5. We have to multiply it by 5, so the answer will be 2.5. okay, now here the unknown ordinate we have to calculate again, LMN. This is LMNO, okay. The load is, the train of vehicle of load is to be applied or to be arranged like this, okay, and then we have to calculate the load into distance, load into particular ordinate, okay. Now LMN is calculated. The maximum bending moment is equal to 20 into 0.75, 10 into m, 15 into 2.5, 20 into n, and 10 into o, like this, okay, LMNO, like this. So the maximum bending moment will be 22.75. 22.75 is the maximum bending moment you will get, okay. So why I have put this 15 kilonewton or just the train of load like this, because this is the most unique pattern of vehicle by which you will get the maximum bending moment. Now suppose if I put this train of vehicle of load 20 kilonewton here, okay, 10 kiloton, then it will be here, then 15 kiloton will be here, and then like this only. But here in that case you will not get the maximum bending moment. So for getting the maximum bending moment, you have to put, okay, you have to arrange and you have to put the vehicle, train of vehicle load in such a way that you will get the maximum bending moment. So it will be always possible when you put the central load at the center. Because if you put the central load at the center, at the apex of the part, then you will get you will maintain the equilibrium condition. Because on left hand side you will get the maximum load, and from right hand side you will get the 30 kilonewton load. Okay, and then multiplying that particular load with respect to their ordinate, automatically you will get the maximum bending moment like this. Okay, like this. So these are the two numericals that we have studied today. Okay, so whenever you may ask to calculate the maximum shear force, maximum negative shear force, and absolute bending moment, first thing you must understand that these are the train of vehicle or these are the train of load will always be given in your examination. These two diagram will always be given, okay, in your examination. Then you have to allow or you have to put your train of vehicle of load in such a way that you will get the maximum bending moment. Okay, so we will solve more variety of such type of numerical in our next lecture. Okay, thank you very much for your joining. Thank you very much. Okay, please write your roll number and name in the comment box for attendance.